What has the biggest influence on the accuracy of a temperature measurement? The sensor, the electronics? No, you, during the planning phase. Watch out for part one of our golden rules of temperature measurement. Hi, I'm Dietmar. I'm senior application engineer for temperature measurement at Endress+Hauser. I'm working in the business for some decades and I want to share my expertise with you. During my career and during countless customer visits, I found out that not the class of the sensor or the wiring is leading to the major mistakes in temperature measurement in process application. It's the planning phase. During the design phase, there the majority of the mistakes is happening. And because of that, and because of this feedback of this customer visits, I've summarized these in the golden rules of contact thermometers. And the major rule is every contact thermometer can only measure the temperature which the primary element, for example the PT100, is really seeing. So that means every thermometer for process application is made of steel, of stainless steel usually. So it's conducting the heat. And so that means it's part of the energy transport. Because typically in the pipe, in the vessel, it's hotter than in the ambient environment. And so energy is transported from the inside to the outside, or for cooling applications in the other way around. So in reality, every thermometer is influenced by the ambient conditions. And it is part of an energy pass, and we have to consider where in this energy pass the sensor is really located. To make you understand, a typical example is the process is hotter than the ambient. For example, for a sterilization application, we have pressurized steam, we have 130 degrees in the inside, and we have 20 something on the outside. If I would touch the flange in an application like this, I would burn my fingers. Yeah, because energy is transported. The hot flange is giving energy to the air by convection. But where does this energy come from? It comes from the heat conductivity of the metal material in the inside. So the energy from the process dissipates to the environment. And that also means if it like this, if there is energy, if there is heat, probably the inner side of the flange is also part of this energy pass. And consequently, there must be a temperature gradient inside the complete thermometer system. A better way to make this understand. What do we know? What do we want? We want to measure the process temperature, and we know that the rest of the thermometer is exposed to the environment, to the ambient conditions. So how does it look in between? Is it cold, 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 hot? Or is it something else? And the simplified way is, it's similar to this. As closer you come to the flange, it becomes hotter. The upper side of the flange is still too hot to touch. The inner side of the flange is hotter, but not at the process temperature. And there is a gradient also in the stem, in the inner side of the thermometer, which is exposed to the fluid. Outside, as mentioned, we have the convection, and inside we have the gradient inside the stem, and this will also change our view to the accuracy of the process thermometer. More about this in the next video. Hope you like it. If yes, watch out for the next video of this series and leave us a comment, a like, or share.